Hello everyone. In the previous class, we have discussed about the finite difference method, the concepts, and different methods of finite difference method. Those are nothing but the backward difference method, forward difference method, and the central difference method. Okay, so all those are used to find out the deflections and bending moments, whatever values in the beams. Okay, that is what we have discussed. Now let us see, let us discuss about the applications of finite difference method for the statically determinate beams. Okay, let us consider a beam which is loaded by UDL, and we know in the third semester, I think all of you have studied in third semester, that's nothing but the slope and the deflection in beams. Okay, that chapter. So in that deflection in beams chapter, all of you studied about this equation, right? We have arrived at bending moment equation M is given by EI D2Y by DX square. This is the equation we have got it actually. So now, using this equation, now let us consider the so EI D2Y by DX square is equal to M. So send this EI the other side, right? And we know also from deflection, I mean the relationship between the bending moment, shear force, and the load, you know the relationship, which are given by dm by dx is nothing but the shear force, okay, and d2m by dx square is nothing but the load acting downwards minus w. Okay, so now you substitute the value of m from this equation here, and this will become d2y by dx square. That total value of m we are substituting here, EI d2y by dx square, and that is equal to minus w. This is from equation number 2. Just we substituted the value of m from here. Okay, that's all. And that is simplified to d to the power 4y by dx square, which is equal to minus w by EI. Okay, so all these things actually you need not remember. Okay, so thing what you need to do is, I'll let you know what to be remembered. So all these things are being discussed to get the final equation which we are going to use for the statically determinate beams. Okay, now, so you are all familiar with these terms, what is y, what is w, what is e, what is I, right? So these are all the terminologies. W is intensity, m is moment at a section, h is the interval. So what you need to do in finite difference method, the finite difference method, the name itself says that difference means finite difference. We will be dividing the given continuum into finite numbers, so finite difference, right? That's the reason why we will have to divide the given span into number of elements. So each interval will be taken as h, that is what here. And y is deflection, l is the length of the span, I mean span of the beam. And I is the moment of inertia, section one, second moment of area. Okay, so now having these equations, now let us arrive at the equation required to determine the bending moment and deflection for beams. Now, in the previous class, we have arrived at this equation from the central difference method. That is nothing but second order derivative of some variable is obtained by yn minus 1 minus 2yn plus yn plus 1. Okay, this is what we have got in the central difference method, which you can see here. Okay, delta square yn, if yn is some variable, y is some variable, and the nth ordinate is given by the difference, second order difference of the nth order is given by minus 2yn plus yn plus 1 plus yn minus 1. This can be rewritten as yn minus 1 minus 2yn plus yn plus 1. That is what it has been written here as well. So second order derivative of nth ordinate is given by yn minus 1 minus 2yn plus yn plus 1. Now let us apply this particular formula for our beams. Now consider a beam of length some L, okay, and loaded with some irregular load W, right? And let this be the bending moment diagram, and you will have the ordinates starting from M0 to M1, like that. You will may have up to M2, Mn, so just like that, Mn minus 3, Mn minus 2, Mn plus minus 1, Mn, Mn plus 1, Mn plus 2. So these are all the ordinates of those bending moment diagram. So actually, for a irregular load like this, it is very difficult to find out the bending moment diagram. Okay. So for such kind of irregular problems, we may need to apply the other method, because finding the bending moment diagram or bending moment value or deflection for this kind of irregular load, it's impossible. So it's impossible by regular methods. Okay. Like maybe by applying equations of equilibrium or by using deflection equations, it is difficult. So such case we need to apply finite difference method. So how to apply finite difference method? Let us see. So now these are the ordinates of the bending moment diagram. What we need to do here is we'll have to apply this equation for this bending moment diagram. Okay. So the second order difference of this bending moment MM is obtained by Mn minus 1 minus 2 Mn plus Mn plus 1. Okay. So now what you need to do, you just substitute this relationship in equation number 2. That's nothing but D2M. D2M is nothing but this one. Okay. We'll be substituting over here. So if you substitute D2M, that's nothing but Mn minus 1 minus 2 Mn plus Mn plus 1 here in this equation. So, and what actually becomes, and we know that dx is nothing but it's a interval between, the distance between two intervals dx, and in our problem, let us consider that as h, okay, as we have considered here, h is the interval. So, dx square, h square, and that is equal to minus w. So, if you cross multiply that is what this equation which we have got. So, Mn minus 1 minus 2 Mn plus Mn plus 1, which is equal to minus h square. This is actually minus w. So, h square will go that side. So, minus h square and w. W, actually that w is nothing but intensity of UDL in that interval. But, for example, if you are considering the bending moment over here in the central difference method. So, what is the bending moment over there? Let us say, for example, there is a that figure is over here. So, over here, bending moment is Mn. Okay. And that particular point, what is the intensity? That is actually called Wn. Okay. So, that is Wn. Next. So, this is the equation for the bending moment. Similarly, now let us consider this equation. Okay. This equation. Equation number 1. And try to relate the deflection. D2y. Okay. Which is nothing but, yeah, this equation. You can consider delta square or d2 square. One and the same, okay? Delta to the power 2 or d to the power 2, y is equal to m by s. So, the same equation you can consider here. And this d2y becomes yn minus 1, 2yn plus yn plus 1. That is what which is being considered here. Into dx square. Actually, the dx square will be below. If it goes to the right hand side, it will become h square. So, yn minus 1 minus 2yn plus yn plus 1 is equal to h square into mn by ei. So, we have got these equations from equation number, this we got it from equation number 2, and this equation we have got it from equation number 1. Okay. So, this is from equation 2 and this is from equation 1. Now, right? So, we'll be finding out the bending moment from this equation and the deflection from this equation. Got it? So, here W will be known. Okay? And by that, you can find out the bending moments. Okay? And then here, moment will be, after finding the moments will be known, deflections can be calculated. Okay? And you may have a question, because there are n number of unknowns here, how to calculate it? So, that we will discuss in actual problem. How we will be using these equations to find out the bending moments and deflections, let us, take up later. As of now, these are the equations. So, In this first method, actually, we will be first finding out the bending moments and then finding the deflections. Okay? But instead, you can directly calculate the deflection, okay, from the third equation. Okay? So, d to the power 4y by dx square is equal to minus w. That's nothing but fourth order difference. Fourth order difference. That's nothing but d to the power 4. You know the central difference method, fourth order difference equation, which is given by d to the power of 4yn is equal to yn minus 4yn plus 1 plus 6yn plus 2. This is the equation. Same thing we will apply over here. So, we will be writing this yn plus 1 first. That's all. Okay. You can apply that and you can get this equation. So, yn plus 1 minus 4yn plus 1 plus 6yn. Okay. And minus 4yn minus 1 plus 4yn minus 2. Same thing we will be applying over here. Okay. And which you can get it equal to, I mean, in this one, if you substitute d to the power 4 here. So, divided by dx to the power 4. So, dx is nothing but h. So, therefore, h to the power 4 divided by EIN, moment of inertia at that particular section. So, either you can use these two equations to find out first bending moment, then deflection. Or, directly you can use the fourth order differential equation to find out the deflection directly. Okay. So, that is what the introduction. So, what we will be carrying out from here is only these three equations. 1, 2, 3. And also, you don't know how to do it. Just remember what are these equations. Okay. And how we got it from the central difference, what we had discussed in the last class. Okay, that's all. Now let us consider some problem and apply this finite difference method to calculate bending moment and deflection. Okay, now, okay, so let us consider first problem, which is nothing but a simply supported beam carried with UDL. So, a beam of length L supports a uniformly distributed load of intensity W kilonewton per meter. Calculate the maximum moment and deflection in the beam. Assume EI as constant. So, EI is constant throughout the length. I mean, the section is same or along the length, right? Now, we need to apply, if it is a normal method or you can calculate the bending moment and deflection, all that by regular methods, that is applying equations of equilibrium, then double integration method or any method you can use to find out the deflection. But assuming this is a complex beam, let us apply the finite difference method over here for this beam. Okay. Now apply the central differences to the moments at various nodal points. So now, in order to consider this, what we will do, we will divide this beam into four parts. Okay, four divisions. Division 1, 2, 3, 4 parts. And let those points be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And let h be the interval between those, h be the distance between two intervals. Okay, and let this be the bending moment diagram. And we'll presume that we don't know the maximum value, because actually we know the maximum bending moment is WL square by 8, but let us assume that it's unknown. Okay. And here, let us assume this as M0, M1, M2, M3, M4 as the ordinates of the bending moment. Let's see how exactly we can calculate the bending moment values from the finite difference method. Okay, now let us apply central differences for this bending moment diagram. Okay, according to the central difference method, we know Mn minus 1 minus 2 Mn plus Mn plus 1 is equal to h square Wn. Okay, this is the equation. Now, let us go on apply, which has been derived from this equation, okay. Now, let us apply this equation, Mn minus 1 plus minus Mn minus Mn plus Mn plus 1 is equal to h square minus h square Wn at different points, okay, at point number 1, 2, 3, because at point number 0 and 4, obviously the bending moments are zeros, okay. So, we need to determine bending moment at 1, 2, 3. Now, So at number one, point number one, n is equal to 1. Okay, here n is equal to 1. Just substitute the value equal to 1. Mn 1 minus 1, 0. Therefore, m 0 minus 2 m 1 plus 1 plus 1, 2. So therefore, m 2, which is equal to minus h square into w, because w is the intensity. At this point, intensity is also w. Okay, let us call this as equation number 1. Right. Now, next, let us apply one more this equation at one more point. Okay. That's nothing but at point number 2. So, this is actually point number 2. At point number 2, this is point number 1. Okay. Point number 1 and at point number 2. Okay. And so, at point number 2, n is equal to 2. Therefore, 2 minus 1, 1. And n is equal to 2. So, 2m2 plus 2 plus 1, 3. So, therefore, m1 minus 2m2 plus m3 is equal to, here also the intensity is w only. So, minus h square w. And interval remains same. Similarly, at point number 2, at point number 3, this will become the equation m2, because n minus 3 minus 1, 2, 3, here m3, 3 plus 1, 4, m4 is equal to minus h square into w. So these are the three equations which we have got it from this relationship. Okay, this relationship. Now what you need to do here is, having these equations, okay, we try to solve these bending moments m1, m2, m3, m1 all. So that can be done by applying simple boundary conditions. What are those boundary conditions? These are the boundary conditions. So you see m0 is equal to m4, okay, which is equal to 0, right? Next, m1, because of the symmetry, m1 is definitely equal to m3. So that we have m1 is equal to m3. That is from symmetry. Now from equation number 1 and 2, if you consider these 1 and 2, equation number 1 and 2, so what do? You just, because you substitute m0 is equal to 0, and then we know the value of here, okay. So 0, and then 2, you have the value of m3 is equal to m1, so this will become m1. So m1 plus m1, 2m1, so this will become 2m1. This is actually from equation number 2. This is from equation number 1. So this is from equation number 1. From equation 1, so m0 becomes 0. Therefore, 2m1 plus m2 is equal to minus wh square. Next, from equation number 2, what actually becomes equation number 2? So in equation number 2, we know m3 is equal to m1 because of the symmetry. So substitute this m3 is equal to m1. Therefore, m1 plus m1, 2m1 minus 2m2. So, which will be there? Minus w square. Now, solving for these two equations, okay, what do you get? So, 2m2, if you simplify it, because this is 2m2, 2m2 minus m2, minus m2, and here, minus w square, minus w square, minus 2wh square, right? Okay, and therefore, now, minus 2m2 minus m2, m minus m2, and this will become minus 2 w h square. Therefore, now minus minus will cancel out. So, m2 is equal to 2 w h square. M2 is equal to 2 w h square. Therefore, and we know that h is equal to, because h is nothing but 1 fourth of, because the entire section is divided into 4 equal parts. Therefore, each part is equal to l divided by 4. Isn't it? Therefore, substitute h is equal to l by 4. So, from there, you will get this one. So, here if you substitute L by square, 2 into L square by 16, it will become, so 8. Therefore, M2 value is equal to WL square by 8. So, that is what we are expecting, right? Because it's an UDL. In case of UDL, the maximum bending moment at center point is WL square by 8. Isn't it? So, therefore, M2 is equal to WL square by 8. Also, now you substitute the value of m2 in the previous equation, any one of them. So, like here, 2m1 plus m2 is equal to minus h square. You substitute that. Okay. So minus 2m1 is equal to R. Okay, we know that m1 is equal to m3, we know that. So here any one of the equation you can substitute. Minus 2m1 minus 2m1 plus, actually there will be minus 2m1 here from this equation, minus 2m1 plus m2 plus m2 any one equation if you substitute the value of m1 you will get it. Okay, m1 you will get it. So here you just take this equation, so minus 2m1 plus m2 is equal to this. If you take it, so m2 will become or m2 we know, so 2 minus 2m1 is equal to send this value the other side, so it becomes like this. So minus, let us consider it, minus 2m1 plus m2 is equal to minus w h square. Now substitute the value of m2. M2 is w l square by 8, or actually let it be 2 h square only. So m2 is equal to 2 h square only, 2 w h square only. One second. So I think it was not visible earlier. So let us consider the first equation, minus 2m1 plus m2 is equal to minus w h square from this equation. Okay, and you let us substitute the value of m2 here. So minus 2m1 plus 2w h square, which is equal to minus w h square. So minus 2m1 will be equal to, send this 2m1 to the other side, that will become minus 2w h square minus w h square. So minus 2m1 is equal to minus 3 w h square, or m1 is equal to 3 by 2 w h square, or m1 is equal to 1.5 w h square. Okay, and we know h square, we know that h is equal to l by 4. You can substitute that w into l by 4 the whole square. So 1.5 WL square by 16, it will be, this is the equation for M1, and that is equal to M, okay. So this is equal, this is the equation for M1, and that's equal to M3. So we have all the values. We got M1 value, M2 value is equal to WL square by 8. And m3 is equal to 1.5 w square by 16, r it can be written as 3 by 2, because 1.5 is 3 by 2, w square by 16, r this is equal to 3 w square by 16 the value. Okay, so these are the values of bending moment. So this is how we will be finding the bending moment values using finite difference method. Next, how to find out the deflection. Now let us consider, okay, okay, now let us consider the same equation, deflection equation. Okay, so let us consider deflection equation, which is given by yn minus 1 minus 2 yn plus yn plus 1 is equal to h square mn divided by e in. So this is what we have in the we have derived in the previous class, I mean earlier, right? So having these values, this equation, now let us proceed. Okay, so consider the nodal points. We need to apply this at different points. Okay, so what we, let us consider this be the deflection diagram. Okay, our elastic diagram. Let y0, yn, y, y1, y2, y3, y4 be the deflections. Okay, now apply this equation at point number 1, 2, 3, 4, I mean 4, yeah, etc. But we know from boundary condition y0 and y4 is equal to 0. Just now apply First one, at point number one here, 1, 2, 3, at point number 1, n is equal to 1, substitute 1 here, so 1 minus 1, 0, 1 minus 2y1, next 1 plus 1, 2, therefore y2 plus y2, which is equal to h square by e I n, because I will be, let us say, because I is same throughout, so the, it is not changing. If you have a varying cross section, we will have to change this one to I, whatever. Now, so h square by ei into, what is mn there at point number 1? That's nothing but 3 by 32 wl square. Okay, substitute that. Next, at point number 2, okay, so at point number 2, this is what actually, earlier I think this was missing. So, here, y0, y1, y2, y3 will be the deflection. This is the deflection diagram. Let 1, 2, 3 be the points. So, I had just now applied here, considering this equation, we'll be applying n, substituting the value of n equal to 1, 2, 3 here. So, if you substitute n is equal to 1, 1 minus 1, 0, okay, and this is 1, 2, y1, and 1 plus 1, 2, so y2, which is equal to h square by ei, and we know the value of m2 value, we know the value of m2 is equal to 3 by 32 wl square, okay, that is what you will do it, we got it, okay. Next, at point number 1, okay, at point number 2, n is equal to 2, if you substitute n is equal to 2, here 2 minus 1, 1, so y1, minus 2 times y2 because 2, next plus 2 plus 1 because at point number 2 n is 2, therefore 2 plus 1, 3, therefore y3, which is equal to h square by ei into what is moment at point number 2? Moment at point number 2 is wl square by 8, okay? So just substitute that m2, right? So by that equation, this is the equation number, you call this as equation number 1, right? This is equation number 2 and equation number 3. Next, at point number 3, here, so substitute n is equal to 3, 3 minus 1, 2, 3, so 2y3 plus 3 plus 1, 4, therefore y4, which is equal to h square by, and we know the moment at m3. M3 is also equal to 3 by 32 WL square. Okay. So that is what we will be getting over here. So these are the three equations. Now applying the boundary conditions. We know the boundary conditions which are given by. So at point number. So at we know that deflection at. Sorry. One second. So these are the three equations. Okay. So next. We know, so by these three equations, what we need to do is, we need to apply the boundary conditions. We know the boundary conditions given by, because of the supports, deflections are 0, y0 and y4 are 0, and by symmetry, y1 is equal to y3, we know from symmetry, y1 is equal to y3, right? Next, okay, let us consider this. Okay, now apply the boundary conditions for equation number 1 and 2. So if you apply the boundary conditions for equation number 1 and 2, in this equation number 1, so y0 will become 0, so minus 2y1 plus y2 is equal to h square by 3 by 32 wl square, and next in this equation actually here, we know that w1 and w, we know that y1 and y3 are same, therefore y1 plus y1, 2y1, that is what it has been written here, so plus 2y1 minus 2y2, okay, so therefore in bracket which is equal to h square by ea w square by 8, since y1 is equal to y3, so it becomes 2y1, right? These are the two equations. Now adding the two equations, so this will cancel out, So minus 2y2, that's 2y2 plus y2, it will be minus y2. Yeah, so minus y2 is equal to h square by e I w l square, right? This side you have, you just need to add them. So you can take h square by e I outside. So it will become 3 by 32 plus 1 by 8 upon simplification. Okay, you will get the value of y2 equal to 7 by 32 h square. Negative sign, send this negative sign the other side. So this will become 7 by 32 h square wl square by ei, which is equal to minus 7 by 32 l and l square wl square by 16 ei, because substitute the value of h equal to l by 4, then this is the equation. So therefore y2 is equal to 7 by 512 WL to the power 4 by EI. Okay, that is the value of W, I mean Y2. Actually, what is the equation for the maximum deflection in case of UDL with at central deflection in case of simply supported beam with UDL? That's nothing but deflection Y is equal to 5 WL to the power of 4 by 5 WL to the power 4 by 384 EI, but we have got 7 by 512 WL to the power of 4 by 4 by WL to the power of 4 divided by EI. But actually speaking, if you calculate those two values, you can see the difference. 7 divided by 512, okay, and just linear mode, I'll just go to. So 7 divided by 32, I mean sorry, 7 divided by 512, how much is that? 0.013. Okay, remember 0.013. And what is 5 divided by 384? That's also 0.013. Almost it is same. 5 WL to the power 4, yeah, 384 EI. Okay, 384. 5 WL to the power of 4 by 384. So they are almost equal. Okay, so this is how you can find out the deflection by finite difference method very easily. And after you know the value of W2, Y2, okay, after you know the value of Y2, substitute the value of Y2 in the above equations to get the remaining values, okay. So you can take any one equation, right, substitute them and get Y3 or Y1. Anyone, so 2y1, this is the equation which you need to consider, 2y1 minus 2y2, which is equal to, you can take this as y1 or y3, one and the same, right? So you consider here 2y3 minus 2y2, which is equal to h square by ei in w square by e8, and simplify it. Okay, send substitute the value of y2 here. Okay, send this value of y2 other side. Okay, simplify it. So if you calculate that one, so that's nothing but here WL square by 8, that's nothing but 1 divided by 8 minus 14 divided by 512, which is equal to R. You just switch on the mathematical mode. Okay, so you can see 1 divided by 8 minus 14 divided by 512, or okay, whatever, 14 divided by 512, which is equal to here you have 25 divided by 256, and further simplification, one second, you have this 2 this side, so if you multiply, this is actually 25, so if you send this 2 this side, so will become 25 divided by 512 WL to the power of 4 by, one second, it should not be 25, one second, let me see, yeah, one more h is there, so you need to substitute the value of h here as L by 4, okay, so L by 4, if you substitute, that will become, finally, you just simplify it, you will get this one, okay, So y3 is equal to 5 divided by 512, and you can see this y3 value is lesser than y2. Okay, it should be